What's up, everybody? What's up, YouTube? Thanks for logging in. Vlog number 2. Got another White Mountain weekend, but today I'm very excited. And the reason I'm excited today is because it's new boat day.
It's my boat.
So the reason today is new boat day is I was loading the truck up last night with my current boat. I saw something. This is what I saw. So I don't know if you saw the last vlog, but if you did, you probably saw my boat go down the river about a mile with my friend Eric chasing it. Probably bashing off of rocks, doing God knows what, but regardless, it's just super old and it's a piece of crap, so good reason to get a new one, so let's go. So I'm in the truck with my wife Deanna, we're out on Route 16. Say hi, Deanna. Anyways, made a quick stop in Dover, pick up my new to me Pyranha Machno. Check it out. Sick. Met a really nice guy named Dino. Kind of unfortunate. He's getting out of paddling because he had a shoulder surgery, I think he said. So yeah, that stinks. But yeah, super cool guy. Gave me a great deal on the boat. Had an apartment full of piranhas, which was kind of sick. So yeah, can't wait to get it on the water. Let's do it. Back up on the Saco. This time I'm out here with Mike's crew. Different flow, different boat. Sun's out, let's do it.
Says she tired, little money, need a big boy. Pull up 20 inch blades like I'm Lil Troy. Now it's everybody flocking, need a decoy. Shorty mixing up the vodka with the liquor. G-Wagon, 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 G-Wagon. All the housewives pulling up. I got a lot of toys.
So the Upper Saco basically starts up in Crawford Notch and runs down into Bartlett. It's a beautiful river. Definitely what I consider one of the White Mountain classics. Straightforward class 3 boulder garden, perfect for class 2 paddlers looking to step it up, or aspiring class 3 paddlers like myself just looking to have fun while sharpening the skills. Just hit it at a low to medium flow and you'll have yourself a good day. Hit it at a super high flow like I did the week before and you'll have a whole different type of day.
That was not fun.
Okay, back to the river. This section's basically made up of 3 larger rapids with wave cranes and small features in between them. The 3 rapids in order are Rowan's, which may have been above where we put on. From what I understand, it's less than a quarter mile down from the gorge, and that's above where we put in. Unless it's one of the rapids we ran leading up the Sawyer Rock, it's kind of tough to say. Aside from that, there's Sawyer Rock, and last but not least, Tweedledee and Tweedledum. Here we are at Sawyer Rock. This one's pretty simple. There's a number of ways you can run this, but what I did here is push all the way to the right like I was trying to bring my bow right into the rock. The current turning left into the drop will put you perfectly in the flow. All you have to do from here is enjoy the ride. Tweedledee and Tweedledum. This feature is the larger and longer one on this section of river. This rapid's fairly straightforward. Depending on the flow, there's a few boulders and holes you'll most likely want to avoid, which is what Mike's explaining to us right now. I'm trying to listen, but my ADHD is getting the best of me and I just want to get back in my boat. So now that I am, let's just read and run, baby. Alright, that just about does it. Another whitewater weekend in the books. New Pyranha was sick. Can't wait to get back up here and get it on the water again. Thanks for logging in. We'll see you next time.